It's a historic day with the left government being sworn in for a second time in Kerala. That's unprecedented. The Kerala High Court on Wednesday declined to set aside the decision to hold a physical oath-taking ceremony to swear in Chief Minister Pinarayi Vijayan to office. Remember, Kerala is under a lockdown right now, and there has been criticism of holding a physical swearing-in ceremony. The High Court did direct the state government to strictly follow all COVID protocols and guidelines, circulars and notifications during that swearing-in ceremony, which will take place at 3:30. Now, even as top-performing ministers like K.K. Shelja have been dropped, and there's been a huge controversy and criticism over that, but three women ministers will be sworn in later today. Now, even as the Vijayan government will take oath in Kerala, winning a consecutive second term with a massive people's mandate, CPM Sitaram Yechuri spoke to NDTV Sneha Koshi on how every decision, including the new cabinet, has been a collective decision.
Well, joining us right now on this historic day as the left is gearing to be sworn in for a consecutive second government like never before in Kerala. Mr. Yechuri, thank you for talking to NDTV. Historic moment. How significant is this for left, for CPIM nationally?
Well, it is a very, very historic moment because it's happening after nearly five decades that you have an incumbent government being re-elected.
And never with the same CM for after 5 years.
Yes, that's what I mean. And with such an emphatic, you know, margins of victory. And this is a resounding vindication of the people's not only appreciation, support, but wanting to have another round of this government in order to improve their livelihood conditions in various ways. But like you said, it has a national implication. And the national implication is very clear that despite all the machinations that were done by the central government and the BJP, all the misuse of the central agencies that was undertaken, all the effort made to rouse communal passions on various issues, the people of Kerala saw through all these machinations. And I think this is one of the few places in the country where the BJP, with a sole MLA in the last assembly, has now been reduced to not having any. This is a resounding slap on the face of the communal forces. And Kerala, I mean, stood up to its tradition and heritage that we are a multi-religious, multicultural, multilinguistic country, and this diversity has to be preserved and cherished if we have to prosper in the future.
Right.
That is the singular message of these elections.
Sir, now, for example, if you look at many unprecedented things happen. Like the left said, Pinarayi Vijayan will be the CM candidate even before the voting happened, even before the results came out. Very unusual for the left to have done this. How do you see this win to have been engineered? Do you see this as many have labeled Pinarayi Vijayan as the captain, as the lead? Is he now becoming singularly the man who is leading the party in ways that has not been led before?
Please understand one thing about the CPM. The leader is, of course, the leader. Every individual has a role. But nobody leads the party except the collective of the party. It is the party collective. Nothing could have been projected but for the collective deciding to project it. Nothing could have been decided the way it is being decided without the collective coming to a collective understanding.
So you're not saying it's one person's role for any decisions that have happened. It is still a very active, strong collective.
Absolutely. Every decision taken, including the question of this cabinet formation, was a decision of the party state committee, and this instance, it was a unanimous decision.
Well, you know, since you mentioned that, your own voters, your own supporters are they are fuming at some pockets with K.K. Shailaja not being found there. A woman minister who won with the largest record mandate. Because there was a principle uniformly put across saying that all the people have to be exempted, therefore she cannot be exempted. That being one. And then you have within the state secretariat objections that were raised seeking for exemption for her, but that was also eventually overruled and it was unanimous. How do you see this?
Well, this is, you see, people having some opinions and some feelings of this nature is very natural. I mean, we've seen this when the candidates were put up. We've seen this when it happened to the finance minister who did not contest. with the PWD minister, who did not contest, one of the senior most ministers. They are very, very senior leaders in the party, but they did not contest. The same sort of a sentiment came up, and then it was said that it's going to very adversely affect you in the elections, but you see the result. You see, people will also realize, remember one thing, India today is a country of 70% of our population is below the age of 40.
And a country where no woman politician has reached the heights because of glass ceiling, just like several other professions.
There's absolutely no doubt about Comrade Shailaja's work. I mean, she's now an international icon, and I'm sure she'll continue to play that role. How it'll be, that we'll see. But the question is, there's no doubt about that at all. I mean, nobody is, discounting it at all. On the contrary, everybody is very proud about
But was merit rewarded?
No, no, you see, as far as women that you were saying, remember, last time there were two women in the cabinet, now there are three. Well, last time also remember.
Being replaced with women's representation.
No, remember, last time Comrade Shailaja was also a first-term MP, minister. She was a first-time minister.
Right.
Yeah, so you don't discount first-time ministers in their role.
Certainly not. We believe that they also would do the best. Thank you so much. Historic day for the left. And Mr. Yechury saying it is a collective decision. With camera person SP Babu, Sneha Koshri for NDTV.